good morning. Happy Thursday. Thank you for coming in to watch here. My name is Jessica. I'm here at the Wellness Center, Madison Health, brought to you live on Facebook. Yay! This video is for anybody to watch at any time. Please share it to any of your friends that want to watch. I know we've all been missing our yoga, so this is a nice way to catch up with each other a little bit. This is a multi-level class, so you can always change things to make things easier or harder for yourself. Feel free to leave anytime you want. If you can only stay for a little bit, you can do the standing part, the sitting part, the laying down part, anything you like. And you can find this video after it's live. You can find it on our Facebook page at Wellness Center at Abson Health. And we are bringing you more classes every day, anytime we can. Find teachers to bring you more live and at-home workouts so we can all make it through this together. All right? All right, we'll get started. Should I go get the music? All right, I'll be right back.
Let's go ahead and get your mat out. Lay it out however you'd like. Change it if you want to. Good morning. This is Lisa Seneker. I will be running the camera this morning, and I'm the manager of the Wellness Center. We are looking forward to bringing you lots of stuff as we navigate this coronavirus together. Please let us know that you're here. Give us a little shout out. Let us know what you're looking for. Hi, Shelly. We're glad you're here. Probably Cora's there with you. And I may be saying hey to some of you out there as Jessica begins. We're going to turn up that music just a little bit more.
It comes up.
Oh, Paula's here. All right.
Hi, Paula.
All our regulars. Yeah. So
nice
let's,
to see you.
Yeah, let's give it another 30 seconds or so. Hey, Aunt Carol. Good to see you. Yes, Cora says she's excited to see Miss Jessica. So any other guidelines, just always make sure to have some water. Just so you know, we will be also producing some Silver Sneakers classes later today that we will be putting on our website that will not be live. We will also have an 8:30 yoga class. That's tomorrow. That's Friday with me, Lisa Seneker. Hey, Bonnie. Good to see you. I'm looking and seeing all of our regulars. How's the voice sound for you guys?
Can you? It's not quite as quiet and relaxing as it normally might be, but we're working with it. Sound good? Sound good? You see me? You know me, I like to work sideways on my mat, but you are welcome to turn your mat any direction you want. If you have any props you want to use, a blanket, a block, a book, anything, have your water or your caffeine nearby as the case may be. So I guess we'll get started here. So we'll start with all of my favorite things here. Standing nice and tall, think about your posture for a second. Spread your toes out, lift your arches, soften your knees. Take a nice breath, find your hips. Make sure you're not too tucked under or too tipped back. Open up your chest, drop your arms. Let your head float at the top without letting your chin run away. And we'll start moving your head. Chest and the face to the sky. Take that a couple times. Waking up the back of the neck. And then find center. Take ear to shoulder. Ooh, this is always the one that lets me know if I slept funny on the neck. Thank you. rest of your spine turn, allowing your hips and knees and ankles and toes to move under you so everything gets a little movement. Getting all the stand practice and hops out. And then bring it to center. And let's start with our breath. So forward bending. Take our inhale, exhale open. Inhale up, exhale in. Exhale forward over the legs. So your hands can find the floor or a support or your legs. You don't want to hang that low. And we'll take a few knee bends here. Bend and stretch. Bend and stretch. And bend and stretch. Soften the knees and roll back up. And take a little step out. We'll do it again. Exhale. All the way out. Again, let your hands find a place, floor or your legs or a support, and take a few more knee bends. Bend and stretch, bend and stretch, and bend and stretch. And then walk yourself over to one side. You can move your support with you. You can hang on to that leg, not your knee. And then we'll take it over to the other side. Soften the knees and roll back up. One more set. You can take the legs even wider if you want, or leave them where you're comfortable. Inhale and exhale. This time we're going to bend one knee and shift your weight over to that side. And then eventually take it to the other side. And just take that back and forth a few times, getting into your hips and hamstrings, whatever you like. If you've got one side that's stickier than the other side, you can hang out over there. You can adjust your lunge if you want to take your legs further. Rotate to get a different stretch. You can. You can hang out in the center if that's what you need today. And then at some point, find your way back to center and soften the knees, roll back up. Walk it back in. All right, it is Thursday. Even if you're watching this on a different day, it's Thursday, so we're going to do it. We're going to be our scarecrow, standing tall, and my elbows are going to pulse up and down. I know y'all have been missing this, right? On the Thursdays we haven't had class. We're going to sit here and warm up our shoulders, our triceps. You can distract yourself. You could take a little moment of balance somewhere, anywhere. It doesn't matter. Or you could just stand. Or you can pace up and down your mat the longer we hang out here because you just need to distract yourself. You know, my favorite is to stretch my toes here. Lift my heels, stretch the backs of your toes. This is normally where I have a conversation about the weather or coffee or food. You know, I like to talk about food a lot. I have not had any pie lately. This is a sad, sad thing. I might have to start baking, learn how to make my own pies. Something to do, right? We're always looking for new things to do. We almost got this. Ooh, and shake it out. Step into your calf stretch. All toes and knees pointed in the same direction. Now the arms pulse up and down behind you. Your palms can face up or they can face each other. Now we're really getting a little between your shoulder blades and keep your chest open, your posture nice and strong. Ooh, a couple breaths. Wow, you don't do this one for a week or two, and it really hurts. Ooh. We can do this. 3, 2, 1, and try the other side. Get into that good calf stretch. Remember, keeping your back leg very parallel with the size of your mat will give you a better calf stretch. It might be a little harder to balance, but even if your foot turns out a little bit, you don't get as good of a calf stretch as if it's very parallel. We're almost done. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Shake it out. Oh, it's been a minute since I've done that. Let's give our arms a little stretch. Let's take that arm across the front. You can move your head around. You might find a little bonus spot. As always, make sure you're not pressing right on your elbow. You can press above it or below it. And then we'll switch over to the other side. Ooh, there that is. I was doing too much raking in the yard yesterday. And then release. Let's also do our tricep stretch, but let's do it with our little plie squat, warm up our legs. Take the legs out wide, knees and toes pointed towards the corners of the mat. Have a seat here, and let's take that arm up and back. You can give the elbow a little pull right here. You can reach around and try to grab your fingers. You can take a little tilt. You can drop something down your back and reach around and grab that. That's a nice way to make that happen. And then switch. Try the other side. Up and back. Give it a little pull. Grab fingers. Drop something down your back. Or take a little tilt. Take it over. Nice, long, up through the fingertips and down through the foot. Nice breath or two. And then pull right back up and face your front. You can choose how wide you want your legs to be for our flat back and twist. When you're ready, inhale up. Exhale halfway down to your flat back like a table. Make sure your knees are not locked. You can put your hands on your thighs if you want support, or you can let them fly if you don't. Or you can take your tiny back extensions if you want to work those hamstrings and glutes a tight little bit. Take our twist, taking one hand to the block or a support, the other to the sky. And you can change the width of your legs to find the right place for you to be able to reach the ground or your support. That'll give you a better twist and less pinching in the shoulder. Straighten out the leg. Spirit to help you. Are you still breathing? You might notice that you get deep rid of the stretch every time you take a nice deep breath. Or you can have your knees and feet a little bit apart and not touching. Just don't do both of them at the same time. You ready? Find a nice tall spine. Sit into your chair. So your tailbone is reaching back. Your weight is back in your heels. You might be able to wiggle your toes. And your hands can go anywhere you want. You can put them on your thighs to support yourself. You can leave them at your heart. Reach them up. Take cactus. And you also have the option, you don't have to stay here the whole time. If you want to practice repetition, if you want to stand up and sit down a few times, you might like that better. Or my favorite, as some of you know, stand up, pick up a leg, and then sit back down. Kind of a little preparation for a one-legged squat. Not bad. You do not have to do that. You can stay hunkered down in your chair. Put your hands on your thighs. It's hard to hold it for a long time. Take a couple of breaths. When you are ready, you can relax forward. Maybe you can take a full ragdoll hang this time. Thank you. walk yourself back up, fix your lunge, and we're going to take a little shift back into our half split. You can sit all the way back. Some people can do that. It bothers my knees, so I don't. I like to hover. And I also like to wiggle my leg around on that hover, too. So. And then, one more. We'll take it forward again. Let's go to our pyramid. Tuck the toes in the back. Straighten out both legs. Hop that back leg a little closer. You can use your block or your book or whatever to help you balance. And then, we'll bend the front leg, spin the back leg out, bring the body back up, and rebound to the front. And we'll do the other side. So turning to the new side, turn the other leg, both hips, both shoulders, and bend your knee, warrior one. You can play here. If you wanted to change to that crescent lunge, you could flip the back heel. Maybe it sinks a little lower. Today. back up and try the other side. Twist and lean. A couple breaths. It might feel like more of a twist than a lean, and that's fine. And then back up. And yes, a little moment right to the front. Lean forward. Find a place to rest your hands or elbows or forehead. You can use your block or book or ball, whatever you've got, to find the place where you can lean forward and rest rather than reach out into the space. We don't always need that. If it feels good to let your spine sway or your legs wiggle, you can do that. I personally love a good spine sway. Inhale up, exhale forward. Let your hands find a place to rest. Sensitive knees. I'm going to start with some cat and cow here. Pull the belly button up around the spine and then drop the belly button down, arch the spine. Do that a couple times. Exhale and inhale. Feel the shape of your back changing. All the different curves of your spine. Don't forget about your hips, that curve that goes out to your tailbone. We forget about that one a lot. And then find a neutral spine. And we'll take a warm-up round. Press back, downward facing dog. Tuck the toes, lift the hips. So we're trying to make a triangle out of ourselves here. May not quite be there. And you can pedal your feet around. Get a good calf stretch. You can shift your hips around. Open up your shoulders. And then we'll take it forward to our little plank. Yay, plank. Now this can be any plank. It could be a plank with your knees on the ground. It could be an elbow plank. This plank may contain an actual push-up. You are welcome to do that, as many as you want. And then we're going to lower to the ground. Even if you put your knees down first, and then lower with control all the way down. Now roll your shoulders back, press into the floor, lift your chest. You might have straight arms, you might have bent arms, you might readjust and put elbows on the floor. That's always your choice. You want to throw in there, you can. If you need a bonus round or if you want to rest, we'll catch up with each other in a second. Take one more little thing together for our back and then for our a little more stretching. So So when you have found your rest, come back to hands and knees, to your table. We're going to take a little balance here. So we'll send out, let's say the right leg and the left arm. So you're working in opposition. You can stay here, or you might make it move. You could grab a foot, if that's something you wanted to do. You can also say, no thank you, I'm going to put my hand back down and just concentrate on my leg. And then release the hand, bend the knee, pulse the ceiling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now tuck this leg in. We're going to come to our pigeon. Lay the side of the leg on the ground and slide the other leg back like someone's pulling it out from beneath you. Thank you. course, take a little leg off the floor. You don't have to. Another nice breath or two. And then eventually roll down your spine nice and easy. And you can find your way to a moment of rest or stretch. You can take your figure four. You could take a happy baby. If you need that moment of rest, you could just stretch out into your shavasana or curl into a ball or flip over or sit up and take a meditation. Any last little moment that you would like. Let us know. And again, I'm Jessica. I hope to see you again.